Hello everyone, welcome to webinar series on Intel Higher Education Challenge 2017. Today's webinar is on Intel Edison and Embedded Linux. So in today's webinar, first we'll talk about embedded systems, then we'll discuss embedded Linux operating system and application development using embedded Linux. Then we'll discuss shell scripting and Vim editor in embedded Linux. Then we will practice some Linux commands on Intel Edison, and we will learn how to execute a script in embedded Linux. So if you want hands-on, then you may require some equipment and some other things. So you require Intel Edison kit, you require two USB 2.0 A male to micro B cable, that is also called micro USB cable. Then you require one power adapter to power up the Intel Edison board and a personal computer to connect with the Intel Edison. In software part, you require a SSH client like PuTTY for Windows. Mac and Linux users only need a terminal. So terminal is already there with Mac and Linux operating system. So first question is, what is the embedded system? So in day-to-day life, we see lot many devices and appliances. If we talk about automatic vending machine, if we talk about video games, if we talk about robotic devices, if we talk about home or household applications, appliances like washing machine, like refrigerator, LEDs, televisions, cameras, automobiles, so many things. So all these appliances or devices either contain a embedded system or based off embedded system as their control unit. So if we talk about in today's world, other emerging embedded systems, we talk about smart watches, we talk about automatic wheelchairs, we talk about navigation system, LED televisions, vacuum cleaners, microwaves, and other devices used in day-to-day life. So these are the emerging embedded systems. Now how these embedded system works, have you ever wondered? So basically, what is the embedded system is? So you will find embedded system all around everywhere. So what are the embedded systems? How we can define embedded system? So embedded system we can conclude is nothing but a combination of hardware and software designed for a specific applications. Examples like washing machine, LED televisions, refrigerator, and so on, so forth. So what basically embedded system contains? It contains a CPU and memory, timers, and other input output ports. So here, Intel Edison can be used as an embedded device that can be programmed as per the application. So if we go in depth of embedded system, you will find nothing but the integrated circuits, four ICs, CPUs, memories, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and all other things. So embedded application development, how we develop an embedded application, how we design hardware, and how we write a program or design a software for a particular embedded application. So we will talk about Intel Edison developer options. So basically, main part of Intel Edison we can say is Yocto Linux. So if Yocto Linux is not running in Intel Edison, then we'll not be able to write a Arduino application, we'll not be able to write application using JavaScripting, we'll not be able to write application using C, C++, Python, and so on so forth. So how a embedded application being developed or how embedded application works. So basically we have source file written in high level language, for example C, C++, Java. Similarly, that source file can be written in assembly also. So when the file is written C, C++, we use compiler. Compiler converts this higher level language into the machine level language. Similarly, assembler converts assembly level language into the machine level language. So application can be written in higher level languages, can be written in assembly, and those applications are needed to be converted into the machine level languages so that machine can understand. So here is the linker. Linker takes the inputs from compiler and assembler and takes input from library and kernel. So basically library contains nothing but the other functions written for APIs, while kernel controls the timing, memory, execution. So we can say the task scheduling, memory allocation, all those things are being controlled by the kernel. So linker takes input from all these parts and make a executable file. So now this executable file that is in machine level language given to locator, while locator further convert this machine level language executable file into the binary file, and this locator also gives the location to store that binary image or binary file into ROM, and then later on from ROM it goes to RAM for the execution. So this is basically build and load process for embedded application programs. This is how embedded application works. So it starts from the source file and goes finally to the RAM. So if we further talk about the embedded Linux application, we can say we write a application using APIs. API stands for application programming interface. And for each API, we have written functions, task group or set of function, maybe different functions are there. And then kernel takes output from these APIs and communicate with the hardware using some utilities. So basically kernel has given various responsibilities like task management, memory management, input output management, and file system management. So if we talk about a typical embedded application, we have user space and we have kernel space. So this is divided into two parts, user space and kernel space. While if we talk about the user space, we write an application, we write a program, and that program written in higher level languages converted using C compiler into the machine level language. There we have system call interfaces which access the kernel, and kernel communicate with the hardware using these applications and other utilities. So basically, as we already discussed, embedded Linux is nothing but a part of Linux operating system. So a operating system comprises of following parts. So main important part is bootloader. So bootloader is the software that manages the boot process of a computer. So when we turn on the computer, when we turn on a device, which program execute first? That is nothing but the boot loader. The next important part is the kernel, and kernel is also called heart of any operating system. It has complete control over everything that happens in a system. That's why it is called heart of any operating system. Daemons are program that runs as a background process. The shell is a text-based user interface for access to an operating system services. So using shell, we invoke the kernel services. And graphical server, this is a subsystem that displays graphics on screen of computer or on monitor. So desktop environment, a graphical user interface for accessing the operating system services. So they do not usually provide access to all features found in the underlying operating system. Applications, a computer program that designed to perform a group of coordinated functions, tasks or activities. So these are the basically part of the embedded Linux. Now we'll talk about the main important part of embedded Linux is shell and editor. So shell is a program which accept our instructions and commands from user using standard input devices like keyboard or any file and passes them to kernel. Basically, shell takes the inputs from the user using keyboard or files to invoke the kernel services. Space slash etc slash shells will give you the information about different shells in our operating system or in our system. For example, bash shell, C shell, T shell, TCH shell, that is called TC shell, K shell, and an X Windows system, that is graphical user interface based. So to find current shell type, you can also type this command echo space dollar shell. That will tell you in which shell you are. So if we talk about the Linux file system, we have different files and folders or directories you'll find in Linux system that I explain here. Slash bin, that contains common program shared by the system. Slash boot, startup files and kernel. Slash dev contains references to all CPU peripherals and other hardwares. Slash etc, most important system configuration files are in etc. This directory contains data similar to the control panel in Windows. While slash home, home directory of the common user, in etrd on some distributions, information for booting, right? And slash lib, library files include files for all kind of programs needed by the system and the users. Similarly, one more command is there, lost plus found. Basically, it's not the command, it's a directory. Every partition has a lost found in its upper directory. File that are saved during failures are here. Another important is slash root, the administrative user's home directory. And you need to be very careful about the difference between slash and the root directory. Slash root, the home directory of the root user. Similarly, slash has been programmed for use by systems and system administrator. And similarly, temp is for temporary user for the programs, libraries, documentation, etc. for all users related programs. So next very important is Vim editor. Vim is a highly configurable text editor built to enable efficient text editing. So this is basically an editor in Linux, like Notepad we have in Windows. It is an improved version of the VI editor, distributed with most Unix systems. Vim is often called programmer's editor. So whatever the script or program we want to write in Linux, we use the Vim editor. So it's very powerful tool for the programming. Vim is perfect for all kind of text editing, from composing email to editing configuration files. So Vim is very powerful editor and most commonly used in Linux operating system. Now we will access the Linux of Intel Edison. So as we already discussed in previous webinar, Intel Edison is running on Linux operating system, and that operating system designed for embedded applications and uses Linux kernel is called embedded Linux. So there are two ways to access the Linux terminal of Intel Edison. One way is using serial cable over serial terminal, and another we can also access through Wi-Fi. So let's access the Linux of Intel Edison. I've already connected Intel Edison with my PC with the help of two USB cables. So this is Teraterm that I'm using for accessing Linux terminal, and this is also called serial terminal. So after connecting, you need to set the baud rate. So we are accessing through serial port. So set the baud rate of serial port to 115200 and hit enter. So your Intel Edison will ask ID and password for logging in. So name is root and password is Edison at the rate FICE. Let me increase the font size so that it can be clearly visible. So now clear to clear the screen. Now very basic command is ls. Ls will list all files and folders in the current directory. So you can see some directories in the current directory and some files also in the current directory. Pw will tell you the path of current directory. So we are in home and root. Similarly, ls hyphen space hyphen l will tell you the details of all files and folders in the current directory, right? And next command is cd. Cd stands for change directory. Cd space slash will take you to the root directory. And if now we will type pw, we'll see we are in the slash. So slash is nothing but the root. Now we will type ls, will list you all files and folders in the current directory. Clear to clear the screen. Similarly, if you talk press cd and hit enter, will take you directly to the home directory. And if you want to make a directory mkdir, so we'll go back to what all are there. So we'll create a mkdir make directory and give the name of the directory, let's say fice. Now you type ls, it will show you another directory fice. Now you can move from current directory to the new directory. Let's say we want to move to the new directory, that is fice. So cd space fice. So we are now in the new directory fice. So if you want to see the content of this directory, type ls. There is nothing in the current directory. Now if you can create a script also, and you can use the vim editor also. So we'll use vi space name dot sh. It is for shell scripting. So it will open the vi editor. Press I. Here you can type anything. So whatever you want to type, you can type here, right? And again press escape to come out from the insert mode, and wq save and quit. Now you will see one file is written. Similarly, if you want to write a Python script file here, so vi space, let's say name dot py, right? Again, you want to type something, type I. Now press escape colon wq. Now you can also execute. Now type ls, see, so name.sh is also there. So you can also execute this file python space name.py. See, hello world. Now we'll go back to the directory, and there I have written a script in Python to blink onboard LED. So one command is there, cat. Cat will print the content of a file on screen. So let's see what is written in blink.py. So cat blink.py. So this is what I have written in this. So this is basically a Python script to blink the onboard LED. So onboard LED is connected with pin number 13 as per the Arduino nomenclature. So we'll clear the screen. Again, we'll type ls to list. Now I will execute the Python script to blink the LED. So Python space blink dot py. Now LED on my board is blinking, and I'm running this in an infinite loop. So to terminate this, type simply control Z. So I have stopped the script. And to develop a IoT application, it's very important to access the Linux of Intel Edison. For further queries, you can contact us on info@fic.in and mentor@fic.in. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.